COVID police are at it again, this time in the United Kingdom. And this time it's not the local authorities, but an informant from within. Reverend Charlie Boyle of All Saints Church in Branston Park, Dorset, is in trouble for not wearing a mask. Pastor Boyle faces disciplinary action because at least one parishioner complained about the COVID rules violation. Here's Pastor Charlie.
I've been accused of singing the last verse of Thine Be the Glory on Easter Sunday as I'm leaving the service. And frankly, that is laughable.
Thine be the glory.
Reverend Charlie could be ousted from his ministry at the church, and that's not a laughing matter. Stop and think about this. A parishioner felt threatened as the maskless pastor passed by, for only seconds, while singing Thine Be the Glory. Oh no! Incoming! Reverend Charlie is spewing COVID-tainted spit throughout the parish sanctuary. Take cover! Folks, do you really think Pastor Boyle would have led Easter services if he had a fever or was experiencing COVID-like symptoms? I don't think he would have done that. Pastor Charlie responsibly cares for his flock, and he's put strict COVID health protocols in place at the church.
We had our own track and trace. We had the QR codes. We put sanitizer in the church hall. I personally put these little red markers, and I've made sure that people have been safe.
I think the agitated church attendee should have taken a more biblical approach. Instead of becoming a snitch by reporting the pastor to the church hierarchy, the offended parishioner should have politely approached the pastor after the service to explain their feelings, regardless of the signs. It's that simple. First, go to the offender. And although Pastor Charlie suffers from asthma, he may risk his own health in the future to be more accommodating of those feelings. But disciplinary action for Reverend Charlie? Nope. That's a step way beyond the pale. Unlike Texas House Democrats flying maskless for hours to Washington, this was not a super spreader event. I don't know about you, but I thank God for fearless Christian leaders and those who sing joyously about the Lord's resurrection on Easter Sunday or any day, regardless of extreme consequences. Well, that's it today from the Global Lane. Be sure to follow us on the CBN News and NRB channels, social media, and our broadcast affiliates. And until next time, be blessed.